You're warm.
And it's a warmer, yeah. That's like a take out your retina. Inshallah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم مددكم ونزلكم سيدي يا رسول الكريم يا حبيب العظيم وأتي الله وأتي رسول أولي الأمر منكم and a reminder always for myself and عبدكم الله جيسو ضعيف ومسكين وظالم وجهل And by the grace of Allah that we are still in existence. Alhamdulillah for all these strange times that we are living in and the concerns that people have. Inshallah we try our best to go over some of the understandings. Right now when we were talking earlier, the concept of zikrs and awrads, a lot of people come from backgrounds with lots of shaykhs and they want to keep adding all sorts of zikrs and recitations. And the reality is not the more you recite the better it is, because according to everyone's level. For us a simple understanding like medicine, if you take it and it's good doesn't mean you take a lot of it and it'd be very good. It can have different effects that insan may not be ready for. In these zikrs they recommend that you from the app do the Naqshbandi awrad at the beginner level and that's enough. All the du'as can be recited from the app, any of the salawats that you want in moderation you recite the salawat for its blessings. As soon as a servant begin to recite too many things and not understanding what's happening, you are putting out a tremendous light. And that light like a Batman sign in the sky that you're saying, here's Batman, and all the devils are now looking at that light and curious, where is that coming from, and they begin to approach you. And the problem is that if you are reciting those and you are not at that stage and you were not given to recite those, you come under attack. So many things begin to attack that person, visions, sights, all sorts of scary sounds, because you're attracting attention that you don't necessarily want. Now in shaykh in his training he's been taught to recite the basics, then they train on how to make their tafakkur, their contemplation. So like everything else it's like a medicine, they're making their tafakkur, their contemplation, their connection is strong, then the shaykh is dressing their soul with a reality. As they increase their zikr their soul is also prepared and they're prepared for what's about to come to each degree and to each level. That means then the zikr that they're doing, their soul has been built up with its madad, it understands how to call for support. And based on that support when they're making a zikr it's an energy coming out. So when these beings try to come that one is a protected one by their practices. But just taking wholesale zikrs from everyone and from every website and can I recite this, can I recite that, and then they're not really even reciting the Naqshbandi awrad consistently. I mean istiqam, keep your firmness in your way and do the minimum and keep it. And this way is something, make it something light and pleasurable, but Allah loves consistency. As soon as you mix too many things, you're not really doing this, you're not really doing that, and that hence where the problem comes, because they contact shaykh, I'm doing this and this and I'm having all these different difficulties. It doesn't make sense. If you were following exactly what the tariqah is prescribing then those difficulties don't make sense. Later they begin to tell you, oh I recite 100,000 this, I recite 5,000 this, I recite this, 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 and that explains then all these different difficulties. So best not to self-prescribe all your medications and follow the turuq, follow the way inshaAllah.
Sayyidi, before the questions, one of the brothers, Frank Mash,
his father is in critical condition. He has the COVID virus. He's asking for, he has it too, but he's okay, but he's
inshallah,
asking.
Inshallah, inshallah, black seed oil twice a day, inshallah, recite Ayatul Kursi du'a from the app, and 7 times a day Ayatul Kursi du'a, asking from Malik al-Khandiyas, Khadam al-Ayat al-Sharif, that to watch over you, recite the madad of the Naqshbandi silsila and the shaykhs inshaAllah. But Allah grant a shifa and a healing and take away every type of difficulty inshaAllah. And at the end of all the talk then we'll recite the Fatiha for everyone
inshaAllah.
That we don't have to, inshaAllah.
InshaAllah. This question is from Dash Gaming Hussain.
Dash Gaming.
Is there any zikr we can continue to recite all day during this time of uncertainty, inshaAllah?
Yeah, inshaAllah. You find the Naqshbandi awrad on the app, and it's highly recommended in this time making istighfar all day long. Astaghfirullah al-Azeem wa atubu ilayk. So we go from morning time till afternoon. Astaghfirullah al-Azeem wa atubu ilayk. That sifatul azeem. Allah's azimat to wipe away all my sins, and that istighfar is a shower and a cleansing. As soon as we ask Allah, Astaghfirullah al-Azeem wa atubu ilayk, Allah's reply is, Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem, inshaAllah. That from the oceans of mercy and compassion they dress us and bless us and take away every type of difficulty. Once we've washed and showered with istighfar, then the remaining time of the day, salawat on Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. InshaAllah.
Sayyidi, this is from Yuv Charmer. Salaamu alaykum Sayyidi, thank you so much. My concern is that I'm not progressing in the required pace that I should be. How can we speed up to reach quicker, especially in these times, shukran.
Yeah, it's a university without walls inshaAllah, that you can watch the YouTube channel, you can watch the videos. This time that Allah giving us, and Prophet described that every time that Allah gives to us we're accountable for. So this is like an isolation and a khalwa that we have a time to ponder and think of what's important in our life. Alhamdulillah, watch the YouTube, watch the channel, watch the teachings, take a playlist and play the videos from beginning all the way to the end, several. Instead of people doing binge video watching on Netflix, turn the YouTube and learn the realities, read from the books, make your salawats, spend your time in tafakkur if you can to meditate and contemplate and to connect the heart. Allah will hold us accountable for the time He's given. So I mean this is an immense ni'mat from Allah that I've given you this time, what are you going to do with it? And those whom we said last night, those whom they want to build themselves and they move towards excess positive, they should be very content from what Allah is going to be dressing upon their souls. Those whom their reality is more towards negativity, then they move towards the negativity. What was once grey will clearly become black and white, inshaAllah.
Sayyidi, this is from Brother Isaiah Aries. Sayyidi, how can we be nothing and believe that we are nothing? I'm very weak and jahil servant and my arrogance takes over me. It takes over and I cannot even have humility. What do I do?
You have to keep believing inshaAllah that if we keep repeating to myself that I'm ignorant, Ya Rabbi, I'm ignorant, and then I watch the teachings because the teachings have an energy, there's a light. Attending the majlis of the zikr by coming online and listening to the zikr, there's an energy that they're sending onto the soul that energizes the soul and begins to push down the nafs and the bad character of the nafs. As long as I'm taking a path in which, Ya Rabbi layla anta subhanaka inni kuntu minal zalimeen, and keep repeating Ayatul Kareem and keep repeating to ourselves that I'm nothing Ya Rabbi, that I'm ana abdukul ajeezu da'eefu zalimu jahal, and that have mercy upon me, forgive me, forgive me. And then taking an accounting of every night that when you sit and contemplate, my Lord, I'm asking, please inspire my heart, what did I do wrong? What did I say wrong? And whom did I hurt with my tongue? And Allah never forgive those whom break the heart of people. Means it's a big gunah, it's a big sin. So that when we identify then at least we know what we're asking forgiveness, Ya Rabbi forgive me, I may have talked harshly, I may have acted inappropriately, please forgive me Ya Rabbi, please forgive me. And then making the istighfar in the day and in the afternoon making the salawats on Sayyidina Muhammad inshaAllah.
And he also added, is there a way to protect ourselves from the waswas of shaitan and doubts?
In the time of meditation, that's why we meditate with sound. Because anytime we're going to isolate ourselves and sit and make our tafakkur, it's with the power of sound. So when we're listening to the salawat, it actually is to block the waswas of shaitan, that when we try to sit and contemplate, last thing we want to do is contemplate in silence. Because that's when shaitan's going to come, has an active audience and begin to teach to the servant and gossip and complain to the servant. Another time is you're going to be attacked is in the wash facilities. As soon as you enter in, it begins to give a khutbah and lesson and teaching. Take no teaching within the facilities. Anything you think is an inspiration is not inspiration, it's the waswas of shaitan. And then the salawats that throughout the day making istighfar, it begins to block that waswas. That's why all these prescriptions are already in advance of what your questions are. Means that when you make your istighfar all day long, you're blocking this waswas. It's the time that we become idle is then the time in which he whispers into the ear to get the attention of the servant. When we're making salawat on Sayyidina Muhammad again it counters any type of waswas coming into the ear inshaAllah.
Sayyidi, this is from Habib Barye. He's saying, Shaykh, if we can't complete the Fajr awrad during the Fajr time, can it be performed throughout the day or at work?
Sure, there's not a problem for that. If you have to do your Fajr quickly and you want to recite the awrad, you copy and paste it in your notes and you can recite it throughout the day. It's a dua and a prayer that has tremendous blessings and takes away every type of difficulty inshaAllah. Not a problem inshaAllah, Allah's kulli amalu bin niyat inshaAllah.
Sayyidi, do you, this is from Wanda Woman. If you could give advice to the youth who haven't entered the way of tariqah, what would you recommend in terms of books to introduce them?
In what language? And because they're reading English.
English.
And our audience is English. Is the website. The easiest is to take the articles from the Sufi meditation. If they have no Islamic background, then our website SufiMeditationCenter.com. Is all entry level for people who are not exposed to Islam but you expose towards energy and meditation. Because you have to have an equal denominator, you're not going to talk in religious terms because then somebody already has preconditioned religious understandings. So the equal denominator in math that they taught us is energy. Everybody's equal in energy and their understanding. Are you building it or losing it? So then you talk to them in general sense. If they have a Islamic background, then the Nur Muhammad has all the articles on tafakkur, contemplation or guidance. If they have difficulty in their life and say, are you trying to really take this path by yourself and you guide yourself and you prescribe the zikrs that you have to do, the awrads you have to do. And then anyone who comes to them and says that there's no need for a shaykh, well that's a shaykh. The one who's telling you there's no need for a shaykh, he's actually the shaykh who tells people to be misguided. So everyone's a shaykh. When your mom says you don't need a shaykh, your mom is the shaykh. So everyone plays the role of guiding someone. So there is no guidance, it's just what are they going to guide you to? Some guide you to go off the cliff and the other ones are trying to guide you towards Allah inshaAllah.
Say, this is from
Nazia.
Bibi. Sayyidi, please, how can we get our loved ones who are not praying to pray in this time and to have strong faith?
Yeah, inshaAllah, better to conserve or to focus on ourselves. That when I focus on myself, make sure that I'm praying, make sure that Allah is happy with me, my actions are good, my actions are solid, my character is good, I'm an example of that reality. And then alhamdulillah, we leave the rest in Allah's hands. If the person is looking at your good character and still chooses not to pray, means that everybody based on their coordinates. We cannot force anyone to do anything. If they look and see that you have bad character and say, well, why should I do anything if you're bad like that, then it's going to be difficult. If they see that we have good character and they choose still not to do and worship their Lord, then that's between them and their Lord. But again, most important is everyone is responsible for their own grave. When you build yourself, pray, do all your practices, then you begin to ask, Ya Rabbi, that forgive me and forgive my children, forgive all my loved ones, dress them from your blessings, dress them from your ni'mat. So then we have credibility and credit with Allah because of our good actions and our good character, inshaAllah. But as soon as we start to focus on someone else, it becomes a deficit within our own account because we're starting to focus so much on someone else that our actions become weakened, we enter into arguments, we enter into fights, and then our own position with Allah will become jeopardized.
Say, this is from the seeker, Assalamu alaikum dear Shaykh, can you give me ijazah for reciting Naqshbandi zikr?
From the seeker who has a different shaykh? That was the question from last night? No problem, good questions you have, inshaAllah. And sure, inshaAllah there's always the ijazah to recite the Khatm-e Khawjagan and to do the zikr for yourself. There's no ijazah to lead a zikr and to do a majlis of zikr without the authority of the shaykh, knowing who you are and what your character is. I recommend anyone out there who was trying to do a zikr in their home and somebody came by and told them, no, you can do a zikr now, you're going to have a lot of problems. If you're not somebody who's been built up and somebody who's been trained, as soon as you do a Khatm-e Khawjagan, it's the cleansing of burdens. Those people who come, their burdens will be coming, their burdens will be staying. And if you're not trained with an energy that enough to take that away, those burdens stay there and you become somebody loaded with difficulties. So it means those are by authorized shaykh, they know who they're going to authorize and that their madad and their support reaches to that person. But it's not recommended just to start doing whatever you want and invite five people to come and do it with you because you're carrying all their burdens and all their difficulties. You're taking a responsibility that you may not know or that you want. But the ijazah to do anything on the app, all of the salawats are by permission, all the du'as are by permission, any of the awrads are by permission. And if you're doing it and you're finding the blessings of it, then include the Naqshbandi shaykhs in your du'a because at least you're using their blessings, you might as well pray for them too, inshaAllah. That's good, inshaAllah we'll get to the Khatm-e Khawjagan, inshaAllah Allah dress you, bless you, forgive us. And that keep everybody safe and keep everybody to take away fear and that to build their relationship, make their connection, make the love and the connection with their heart to Sayyidina Muhammad and to be dressed and blessed by these realities. And that Allah give us a life in which to see Shab al-Barat, Nisf al-Shaban and all its blessings and all its lights inshaAllah. Ila sharaf al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alayhi wa sahbihi kiram. ولمشايخنا في طريقة النشبندية العليا وسائر وساداتنا وصدقين الفاتحة.
Welcome to Muhammadan Way YouTube channel, your premier destination for videos on Sufi spirituality, classical Islamic teachings, and realities of the soul. With a library of over 1,000 videos and new titles uploaded weekly. Join us to discover true meaning and inner peace in our often troubled world. Click the link now to subscribe.